Today, we're diving into the exciting world of generative AI, or Gen AI for short. With new models and applications emerging daily, it's important to stay ahead. To help you get started, we'll guide you through the essentials, key terminologies, using model APIs, building AI applications, and customizing models with RAG and fine-tuning. Let's dive in and unlock the potential of Gen AI together. Let's start with the first step, understanding the Gen AI terminologies. AI refers to the development of computer systems that can perform tasks that typically require human intelligence. It's a discipline like physics. It includes various subfields, such as machine learning, natural language processing, computer vision, and more. Machine learning is a subset of AI that focuses on enabling computers to learn and improve from data without being explicitly programmed. It involves training models on data to recognize patterns, make predictions, and take actions. And there's deep learning, which uses artificial neural networks and is a subfield of machine learning. NLP, or natural language processing, is a subfield of AI that focuses on enabling computers to understand, interpret, and generate human language. It involves tasks such as text classification, sentiment analysis, machine translation, and text generation. Deep learning models, particularly transformer models, have revolutionized NLP in recent years. Speaking of transformer models, they are a type of deep learning model architecture introduced in the famous paper Attention is All You Need in 2017. They rely on self-attention mechanisms to process and generate sequential data, such as text. Transformers have become the foundations for many NLP models, such as BERT, GPT, and T5. They've also been adapted for other domains, like computer vision and audio processing. Now, let's talk about Gen AI itself. Gen AI, short for Generative Artificial Intelligence, refers to AI systems that can generate new content, such as text, images, and music. It's a subset of deep learning. Gen AI models can generate novel outputs that resemble the training data. They use deep learning models to learn patterns and representations from existing data. An important concept in Gen AI is the Large Language Model, or LLM. LLMs are a type of AI model trained on vast amounts of text data to understand and generate human-like text. These models can perform a wide range of language tasks, from answering questions to writing essays and even coding. LLMs are at the heart of many Gen AI applications, which we'll discuss later. Lastly, let's touch on prompt engineering. This is the practice of designing effective prompts to get desired outputs from Gen AI models. It involves understanding the model's capability, limitations, and biases. Effective prompts provide clear instructions, relevant examples, and context to guide the model's output. Prompt engineering is a critical skill for getting the most out of Gen AI models. Now that we covered the terminologies, let's move on to using the model APIs. Today's video is sponsored by PropelAuth. If you're tired of managing authentication yourself, or you're using an auth provider that's more expensive than useful, give PropelAuth a try. PropelAuth provides simple abstractions for a user, a tenant, and roles and permissions, meaning that you never have to think about the low-level details again. SDK are available for popular frameworks, making integration simple. No credit card is required to get started. You can get their growth plan at 50% off for 6 months with code BITE24. Check them out at propelauth.com, link in the description below. Most generative AI models are accessible through REST APIs. To get started, you will need to obtain API access from the desired platform, such as OpenAI, Anthropic, and Hugging Face. Once you have your API key, you can authenticate your request to the Gen AI model endpoints. Authentication usually involves providing the API key in the request headers or as a parameter. It's very important to keep your API key secure and avoid sharing it publicly. When using these APIs, it's important to follow best practices to ensure reliability and efficiency. Optimize API usage by carefully selecting the model parameters, such as maximum number of tokens. This is necessary to balance the desired output quality with costs. When making API requests, be mindful of the rate limits imposed by the platform. Exceeding the rate limit may result in API errors or temporary access restrictions. Now let's talk about building applications using AI models. There are several use cases for Gen AI-powered applications across various domains, including marketing, customer support, business and finance, and education. Let's say we want to build a chatbot that uses an LLM to provide personalized book recommendations. Here's how we'll approach it. First, we'll choose an LLM provider, considering factors like pricing, availability, and API documentation. Then we'll set up a development environment, getting an API key, and installing necessary libraries. Next, we'll design the chatbot's conversation flow, planning out questions to gather user preferences and determine how to present recommendations. For implementation, we'll use a web framework to build the application, creating a user interface and the backend logic to handle interactions. We'll then integrate the LLM, defining prompts to generate personalized book recommendations based on user preferences. After processing and displaying the recommendations, we'll refine the chatbot based on user feedback. Finally, we'll deploy the application and set up monitoring to track performance and user interactions. This process showcases how we can leverage Gen AI to create intelligent, personalized applications that provide value in specific domains. Now let's talk about making AI model your own. Imagine having a model that's not just smart, but smart about your specific needs. That's what we're aiming for here. There are two main techniques to achieve this: retrieval augmented generation, RAG, or fine-tuning. Let's break them down. First up, RAG. Think of RAG as giving your AI model a personalized library. It allows your model to access external information sources, your databases, documents, even the internet, in real time. This means that the model can pull in the most up-to-date and relevant information to answer queries specific to your business. Here's how RAG works. When a user asks a question, the system first searches its external sources for relevant information. It then feeds this information to the AI model along with the question. The model then crafts an answer using both this retrieved information and its own knowledge. It's like having an expert who not only knows a lot, but also knows exactly where to look for additional information. The beauty of RAG is that it combines the strengths of information retrieval and language generation. This leads to more accurate and relevant responses, especially when dealing with complex questions that require synthesizing information from multiple sources. Now let's talk about fine-tuning. This technique adapts a pre-trained AI model to your specific needs, improving its performance on domain-specific tasks. We start with a foundation model like GPT or Llama, which has broad knowledge from training on vast amounts of general data. Fine-tuning then tailors this model to your specific domain or task dataset. We test the model's performance using a validation set and refine the process as needed. The result is a model that combines broad knowledge with expertise in your domain. With fine-tuning, you create an AI that understands your unique challenges and speaks your language, truly making AI your own. Generative AI opens a world of possibilities for developers and businesses. There are numerous Gen AI models and platforms to choose from to build innovative applications and solve complex problems. If you like our videos, you might like our system design newsletter as well. It covers topics and trends in large-scale system design, trusted by 1 million readers. Subscribe at blog.bytebytego.com.